Alrighty, what's happening, man? This is Boss Golf, back with some more streaming videos. This time we're going to be streaming let me make sure we should be good. We don't want this to go. We'll be streaming some Skyrim today, and I want to test out, haven't streamed Skyrim in a minute, but today I want to test out this Creation Club. And for the Creation Club, let's go to it. For the Creation Club, they have available a free download, which is survival mode. I believe this is free for, I'm honestly not too sure about the dates. By the time this gets posted, I'm pretty sure that it won't be free anymore and you'll have to pay. But for those that are unaware, that are watching this like on the archive streams and shit, archives on YouTube, Creation Club is basically paid mods for Bethesda's two mainstream games, which are Fallout 4 and Skyrim, Special Edition Skyrim. Now, there are already mods on here, like on the special editions of Fallout 4 and Skyrim. You already have mods, but those are made by the community, and they're free. Whereas these are, basically, these mods, I really don't know how to explain them without dilly-dallying too much and going, honestly, into a rant. And that's not what I want to do just yet. I actually want to try some of this out. I will say, like, as far as some of these, from what I've seen and things like that, a lot of these are kind of useless if you're not somebody that's on the PlayStation 4, if you're not somebody that's on the PC or Xbox One. I know PlayStation 4, there's a lot of limitations, and I'm gonna say confidently that I believe half of that is due to hardware limitations, and then the other half is more than likely just BS. But only real use I see for this Creation Club is for PS4 users. Other than that, if you have a PC or if you have a Xbox One, I really don't see the purpose of you getting these. Other than maybe you want to try them or you want to review them for yourself or just see what they're about. Because mods, they're already created by a bunch of talented creative modders in the community on the Bethesda.net forums and site. And if you're on PC or Xbox One, you can get a lot of stuff to be textured to look how they look in the game, how they're looking right here. So today I'm gonna test out survival mode because from what I've seen, it's the most useful paid mod, or in this case, it's free for right now, but it's the most useful paid mod that I've seen on here that that deems to be a challenge, yet at the same time, I don't know, it looks promising. And then it also is supposed to work with all of your mods, but that's the whole point of this. I want to see if it's worth it, and especially since it's free, I want to review it, and I definitely want to see, most importantly, if it works for mods, because I only bought the special edition for Skyrim. I already have this game for 360. I only bought this for PS4. For the mods, and if this doesn't work with the mods, which I've been seeing, I haven't tested myself, if this doesn't work with the mods, that's gonna be kind of upsetting. So they said it is promised to work. Does not enable until after you leave character generation. Okay, so we'll do this. And before we get into this, I'm going to start up my mods. I probably need to update some, but I'm going to start up my mods, and I'm going to start up a completely new character because I have a character that's like at level 200 and something like that. The survival mode looks promising. I want to see if it delivers how it says it's going to deliver. And I want to play on legendary mode with a brand new character. So enough dilly-dallying. We're going to ride into this. And as always, as I tell you guys, like I said on the previous videos I did with Battlefront, if you're watching this on the archive streams, try and get into a consistent habit of doing like the intro and outro things. I'm going to get that set up soon and everything, so that way I'll be able to play it from the PS4 if I can. If not, then I'll just have to somehow work around that. But other than that, let's ride into this. Let me get started on these mods. Let me load my mods up. Which actually I can't do anything with my mods until after I do character generation. So we'll go in here, we'll start up my shit, and now we'll ride. Other than that, I hope y'all chilling. Hope y'all having a great day, and all that jazz. Great month, whatever month, year end, or year or timeline, fucking dimension. I don't know. All right. So, I got some stuff that I need to upgrade. Upgrade. Got some glossy titties on the screen. Easy weather change. My library mod. My mod's downloading. Okay. Yeah, I'm definitely going to have to get my shit started. I really am hoping this works with my mods. Especially like the weather mods and things that I got set up. Especially things like this, like Deadly Joggers, Deadly Bandits. I already know, especially these two mods are still going to have they call it the gray face bug, gray face issue, but if you're on PS4, it can't be helped. So blah, blah, blah. A lot of this stuff is honestly, let me go to my load order and see how I got this set up. I guess this is a super cheap mod. Might honestly use this. 10 health per level. That'll be good for legendary mode. Okay. Faster non-combat skills advanced. Skill up. Oh, these are the cheat books. Faster leveling. Grorian Skyrim calendar. No essentials. Morrowind style. No essentials. Fendrix Maverick sounds improved. So we're gonna work this, and I'm really hoping it works with all of the mods I got set up. Easy weather change. Oh, that's the spells. A lot of the spells. So you can control the weather. Okay, so I'm gonna undo all of this and then I'll redo it after. The game actually starts. So some of this works. Or I guess I can have them up. I haven't played this this thing modded for a minute. There's so many damn games that came out this year. So many things that I've been playing. Demos, betas, you name it. New. Just gonna make sure everything's all right. Heterochromia. Hardcore dragons. I'm not sure if I want to turn this on. We'll see. No dragons. Unrealistic glossy skin. That's my favorite one. All right, which needs updating? Skyrim hair colors. Fendrix Magic World. Multiple follower system. This is the one I really hope it works with. I'm hoping it works with this one the most. If not, I'm gonna have a problem with various dragons. Realistic AI detection. Realistic AI detection is after this. Let me go back. Let me go to this. Let me update. Reorder. Dragons. Well, let's do magic. Fendrix Magic World. That's after Heliomancy spell pack.
multiple followers. So. I'm pretty sure that's near the bottom, right? Because that's a very powerful one.
Yep.
That's after Circlets with Magehoods. Let me see what he updated on this.
Yeah, this is actually a pretty neat mod. Especially considering once you get to like a certain level, you start fighting nothing but legendary dragons, they only look a certain way.
Okay, so let's do this. And supposedly,
with the goddamn with the Creation Club thing, you can only level up by sleeping. So that would be interesting to see how that actually works. And you know what? I can't activate these before I start the game. So let's do that. Let's do that. Let's go immerse leveling. We can skip that. Actually, do I want to keep that on? Let's keep it off for now. Possibly. And see how fast we level up. No essentials, Sidic robes, that's arms and rage. Probably all. I turned all this off because I thought you wouldn't be able to use it, but. All of this should be able to be activated
when the game turns on. Bit of conjuration. All of this. Give me all of this. My skill on this. Immersive fire frostbite. Summon explosive chickens. Unlimited summons. Craftable vamp armor. Actually, I'm gonna turn this on. Just in case I want to. I feel like cheating. Just in case. Craftable vamp armor. Look at this dragon bones. I'm actually excited to get this started up again. Oh shit, no, not restore vanilla. Alright, so it's loaded. Let's do this. Let's create a new character. Fucking playing Skyrim again. This is exciting. Brand new. Trophies disabled. Yes. Let's do it. Oh, man. This is another game, too. Like, I know I haven't played it for a while. And once again, that's because I've been playing other things. But I can never get tired of playing this game. I don't care how many times I've beat it. It's just that fucking cool. It's like one of those things where I can explain to you why, but at the same goddamn time, I can't explain to you why. It just is what it is. That's some real shit. Never get tired of seeing the intro. Never get tired of seeing Bethesda Game Studio. Even with all of their Creation Club bullshit, this game never gets tiring. I fucking love it. You may say Boscoff, you're too enthusiastic about video games. And you know what, you fuck? There's no such thing as being too enthusiastic. And at the same time, you're right. But goddammit, when something is good, it's fucking good. When something is good, it's fucking good.
Finally awake. You were trying to cross the border, right? Walked right into that Imperial ambush, same as us, and that thief over there.
Damn you, Stormcloaks. Skyrim was fine until you came along. Empire was nice and lazy. If they hadn't been looking for you, could have stolen that horse and been halfway to Hammerfell. You there, you and me, we shouldn't be here. It's the Stormcloaks the Empire wants.
We're all brothers and sisters in vines now.
Shut up back there.
What's wrong with him, huh?
Watch your tongue. You're speaking to Ulfric Stormcloak, the true High King.
Ulfric? The Jarl of Windhelm? You're the leader of the rebellion. If the captured you. Oh, gods. Where are they taking us?
I don't know where we're going, but Sovngarde awaits.
No, this can't be happening. This isn't happening.
Hey, what village are you from, horse thief?
Why do you care?
A Nord's last thoughts should be of home.
Rorikstead. I'm from Rorikstead.
General Talia, sir. The henchman is waiting.
Good. Let's get this over with.
Sure. Mara, Dibella, Kinnereth, Akatosh, Divines, please help me.
Look at him. General Tully is the military governor. And it looks like the Dalmor are with him. Damn elves. I bet they had something to do with this. This is Helgen. I used to be sweet on a girl from here. Wonder if Velod is still making that mead with juniper berries instead. Funny. When I was a boy, Imperial walls and towers used to make me feel so safe.
Whoa!
Why are we stopping?
Why do you think? End of the line. Let's go. Shouldn't keep the gods waiting for us.
No, wait! We're not rebels!
Face your death with some courage, thief.
You've got to tell them! We weren't with you! This is a mistake!
Step towards the block when we call your name. One at a time!
Empire loves their damned lists.
Ulfric Stormcloak, Jarl of Windhelm.
It has been an honor, Jarl Ulfric.
Raelof of Riverwood. Lokir of Rorikstead.
No! I'm not a rebel! You can't do this!
Halt!
You're not gonna kill me!
Archers! Anyone else feel like running?
Wait. You there. Step forward. Who are you?
And here we go with the character creation. I already got a where? I'm gonna get a red elf. So you can. Imperial High Elf. The tallest. Dark Elves. Merton. Argonian. I think I'm gonna go with the wood elf this time. Yes, let's go with the wood elf. Let's do that. A female wood elf. Presets. Let's see what you got. This might go with the first one. Just because. Skin tone. Pale or tan wood elf. You know, I already made a change the preset, lose your change, hold up, cancel. I already have a, extremely tan wood elf on the other one, so I guess I'll do an extremely pale. What else? We'll go somewhere in the middle, like right. I mean, it really doesn't matter. This is fine. Actually, that's fine. Okay. Yes. Wait. Sure. Yeah. Complexion. I can't tell if those are like, are those freckles? I don't know. I'm just gonna keep it like that. Dirt. You don't need any dirt. You're fine. Color. You know what? We might just keep your face just like that. Let me take off the scar. Let me look at the scar again. I mean, because there is the face changer in Skyrim, so we can change these at any time. Change your complexion, your skin tone. Yes, that's fine. I like that. We'll start you off as a pale wood elf and then, like, kind of work our way to an immersive. Maybe you got a tan or something. Yep, we'll start just like that. More paint color. Not gonna do too much. Not going to do too much. Face, nose type. Oh shit, I fucked up. I fucked up. Let me go back to the presets. Yep. Change the presets. Keep it like that. Keep it like that. Hey, just accept the scar. Take the scar. You don't need the scar right now. You haven't been through shit. Strong height. Blah, blah, blah. Keep color. Left line. Snow. Ice. Ice shape. Change that shape. Oh. Is that really a wood elf right now? Who knew? I color. Oh god, this is where shit gets tricky. We got the heterochromia thing going, which is actually a nice addition. That's a nice mod. That's actually a mod I can appreciate. Those are cat eyes too. Are those regular eyes? I'm trying to be able to tell. I don't know. That's nice. Yes. Yes, that's nice. Do we really not want to change the face? I could spend forever on this. I'm probably going to. I'm probably going to. Eye shape, eye height. I would. I dip. Boom, with
Very serious and stern, you are. You can have your brows raised, just as if you're not. For some reason, this looks extremely good right now. It might be the TV I'm playing on. I changed screens, so. Or maybe the update. There's been various updates of this game. Bro, with. Ralph Ford. Mouth. What did we have him before? Yeah, I know. Don't even. Just don't, Bosco. Just do what you do. Here. Now, hair color, there's so many various options. Apparently, there's two new options. Oh, there's four new options, excuse me. The newest one. This one here is good. Okay. So make sure you got everything right.
Make sure we're looking all right. Ugh. Ooh. Finish and name your character. Yes. You know, so I sometimes forget that this is a thing while I'm sitting here bushing while I figure out what to call this character. I sometimes, like, this is a thing, but honestly, it's like, I feel it. Sure. Let's, sweet and simple.
Not many wood elves would choose to come alone to Skyrim. Captain, what should we do? She's not on the list.
Forget the list. She goes to the block.
By your orders, Captain. I'm sorry. We'll make sure he remains our turn to Valenwood. Follow the captain, prisoner.
Ulfric Stormcloak. Some here in Helgen call you a hero. But a hero doesn't use a power like the voice to murder his king and usurp his throne. You started this war, plunged Skyrim into chaos, and now the Empire is going to put you down and restore the peace.
What was that?
It's nothing. Carry on.
Yes, General Tullius. Give them their last rites.
As we commend your souls to Aetherius, blessings of the eight divines upon you.
For the love of Talos, shut up and let's get this over with.
Our beloved, as you wish.
Come on, I haven't got all morning. My ancestors are smiling at me, Imperials. And you say the same.
Now?
You imperious bastards!
Justice!
Death to the Stormcloaks!
As fearless in death as he was in life.
Next, the Wood Elf.
Here it is again. Did you hear that?
I said, next prisoner.
To the block, prisoner. Nice and easy.
What is that thing? Could the legends be true?
Legends don't burn down villages.
to move now. Up through the tower. Let's go.
All right, let's change a couple of things. Let me check something real quick. Do I now have survival mode on? It said after character generation. Let me save and then, to enable survival mode, open pause menu, settings, gameplay, and check survival. Survival can be enabled using any difficult setting for maximum challenge. Survival mode will last or difficulty. Either I have to wait until the very beginning part of the game is over, or it does not work with mods.
Another second. Up there is the dragon. They both are dead. They're hurt, but they'll live. Let's go. Just need to.
The defense.
God's guide you, Hedmar.
Stay close to the wall!
Thank you.
Alright, let's try it now. Oh, it's still not on. So I'm going to save here. After I kill these mooks.
We'll meet again in Sovngarde, brother. Looks like we're the only ones who made it. That thing was a dragon. No doubt. Just like the children's stories and the legends. The harbingers of the end times. We better get moving. Come here. Let me see if I can get those bindings off. There you go. You may as well take Gunnar's gear. He won't be needing it anymore. All right. Get that armor on and give that axe a few swings. I'm going to see.
Let's save it.
Some way out.
So either it you have to reload it and execute it again, or it does not work with. There's a mod I have that it does not work with. Can be turned on or off in settings menu. For details, consult help. If you start a new character, survival mode does not enable it until you leave character generation. Well, it's installed. So let's try loading. Cause it worked with other mods I had on when I tried loading it up the other day on another character that I had the mods turned on for. It worked. If it doesn't work, that's going to be upsetting, because they said it should work with everything, and it doesn't. Yeah. There's a mod it doesn't work with. If I have to take a guess, it's more than likely the leveling. Something to do with the leveling. I'm gonna look it up right now. Because that's kind of upsetting. Like I said, it's supposed to just work.
isn't it?
You know what? Maybe I need to get out of. I'm gonna try beating this first level first. I'm gonna try beating this first level first and seeing if that works. And if it doesn't, then I know I have a mob that interferes with it. So let's take this, throw these on, and throw this on. Damn, level 18 already? Fuck. This is legendary mode, alright. I'm about to get fucked. I was about to get fucked. I'm gonna take your blade.
Dragon brings the whole tower down on our heads.
Actually, let's go armor. What kind of armor do I have? This should be light. Yep.
Doesn't give up easy.
Damn, y'all was waiting at the door. Oh, bent him over. Fine, pal.
Done. Let's get moving. Troll's blood. It's a torture room. Come on. Where are you?
There's a lot going on.
No, I haven't seen him since the dragon show.
Ooh, I'll take the hood though. Hold on.
It's like there's something in this cage. Locked. See if you can get it open with some picks. Might need that gold once. Grab anything useful and let's go.
Imperial dogs. There's nothing that's too low for them.
Where did Kraloff go? We know. Why are you
just
waiting?
Keep putting one foot in front of the other.
Come on. Alrighty. Quick save here.
Orders are to wait until General Tullius arrives.
Oh, they found us. Come on. About to be a battle. About to be a battle. Oh shit, already? Shit. Oh shit! Goddamn friendly fire, something serious in this game. Wasn't even wearing the braces. These are even more than the braces. Okay.
Let's see where this goes.
Oh, do I have an arrow? I got a goddamn arrow in the knee. Look at this shit. I'm gonna quick save because these spiders can be bastards. Speaking of.
Hold up! There's a bear just ahead. See her? I'd rather not tangle with her right now. Let's try to sneak by. Just take it nice and slow. And watch where you step then.
Or if you're feeling lucky, you can take this bow. Might take her by surprise.
Go ahead. I'll follow your lead and watch your back.
Meow.
Was close.
Okay, here it is. So it wasn't a mod that was blocking the way. I needed to wait until I finished the basically the prologue of the game. So we're good. Which I was really going to be kind of upset if it didn't work with some of the mods. I know, which would make sense. There are probably some UI mods that it won't work with. Because this thing mainly, well, not mainly, but one of the things it mods is the UI. So, that makes sense. But, yeah. Adds the need to eat, sleep, and stay warm. Which, one of the reasons I did get this mod, one of it's cool, is because I was already kind of playing Skyrim like this. Like, fast travel is cool if you're trying to get somewhere fast, or if you, like, got a bunch of items. And you're over your carry weight and you use a carry potion and you're trying to get somewhere quick, that's cool. But as far as I like just being totally immersed in Skyrim, and I was already looking for a way to do that. This is one of the ways that adds to that. So as far as this being worth it, even played it yet. I've seen some gameplay on it. I feel like it can be worth it, especially for PS4 users that don't have the capabilities of PC or Xbox One users. So if they start doing this, basically giving like test runs of mods 100% off on the Creation Club, that'd be cool, especially if they're worth it. So let's enable this. Survival mode's already on. All right, we're good. This would be nice.
There he goes. Looks like he's gone for good this time. No way to know if anyone else made it out alive. But this place is going to be swarming with Imperials soon enough. Better clear out of here.
And I'm assuming that this mod, it affects the... You feel comfortably warm. You're refreshed, not hungry. Plasma blood gives you 50%. Oh. It's not... They added resistance to fatigue. Nice. That is new. That definitely is new. Because originally it was just resistance to disease and poison. But, resistance to fatigue, that's cool. I'm curious as to what other resistance... There's the other races.
My sister, Gerda, runs the mill in Riverwoods, just up the road. I'm sure she'd help you out. It's probably best if we split up. Good luck. I wouldn't have made it without your help today.
I like the heterochromia mod. That's like one of the coolest mods, I think. Mm-hmm. Meow.
Scratch on the door when you need in.
You know, you should go to Windhelm and join the fight to free Skyrim. You've seen the true face of the Empire here today. If anyone will know what the coming of the dragon means, it's Ulfric.
Ooh, this is where that oh damn. I'm definitely gonna need the quick save because I have that one mod. Well, I already quick saved. I have that one mod turned on, which might be a problem. Hunger Witches reduces your total by a dark region in the stamina bar. Hunger also affects how quickly you can attack with weapons. Eat food to reduce your hunger. Cooked meals are significantly better at restoring hunger than raw, uncooked food. Eating raw meat may lead to contracting food poisoning.
See that ruin up there? Bleak Falls Barrow. Never understood how my sister could stand living in the shadow of that place. I guess you get used to it. These are the Guardian Stones, 3 of the 13 ancient standing stones that dot Skyrim's landscape. Go ahead, see for yourself.
Let's do the Mage Stone.
Mage, eh? Well, to each his own. It's not for me to judge.
There's about to be a battle as soon as we hit this place.
Remember, this isn't Stormcloak territory. If we're ahead of the news from Helgen, we should be fine. As long as we don't do anything stupid. If we run into any Imperials, just let me do the talking, all right?
And then weight is affected. Yeah, weight, carry weight is, there's a 150, they subtracted the carry weight by 150. So I wonder how much you have to eat to... You must have to eat a goddamn full course meal. What are you aiming at? Oh shit, that's what. I might have to turn it off until we, Holy balls. Yeah, no, that might have to get turned off just for the moment.
You know, you should go to Windhelm and join the fight to free Skyrim. You've seen the true face of the Empire here today. If anyone will know what the coming of the dragon means, it's Ulfric.
Yeah, so let me go into quick save. And then quit and turn off. This mod real quick. Turn this one off for now.
turn this one off for now. Yeah, download at a high level. Or what about the bandits? You have to download that on a high level. Yeah, we'll keep the bandit camps off for now. Like all the extra enemies. Hardcore enemies, hardcore boss. Legendary creatures, we'll wait. I don't have no problem doing that. Yeah, these popular Sky Realm. Just for now. Just for now. That way we're not getting attacked and dicked down by Draugrs and all that other bullshit. Let me see here. Let me see if it actually takes. Let me eat some bread. Let me eat all this cabbage. And honey tree nut. And see what that does. Nothing. Yeah, definitely so far. I see the benefits of Creation Club. I'll say the plus side to the Creation Club is for PS4 users that can't do the shit that Xbox and PC users can. A lot of this shit is just honestly unnecessary. And not to mention about what I've hear that's been happening as far as... the payout and how the creators, the original creators of the mods are getting paid. If that's true.
Yeah, so I like this. You actually need to eat now. There's a reason to eat all the delicious looking food that was in the game.
We're ahead of the news from Helgen, we should be fine. As long as we don't do anything stupid.
Don't worry, I saved you guys the trouble of having to battle some hard enemies. I think we'll wait till like level something, I don't know.
You decided to come with me. We're almost to Riverwood.
Fatigue. You're tired, which reduces your total available magicka, represented by a dark region. So fatigue reduces magicka, hunger reduces stamina, and cold reduces health. Fatigue also decreases how quickly you recover magicka and stamina. Also, it increases both. Effect is potions. Sleep in a bed to reduce your fatigue. Sleeping indoors allows for more restful sleep than sleeping. Yeah, we would. If I would have kept those on, we would have entered this town. Would have been a bunch of fuckery going on. We'll wait for that. There's no problem with waiting for that.
Looks like nobody here knows what happened. Come on.
What?
Gerda's probably working at her lumber mill.
Let me see what it says.
Gerda.
Gerda, Mara's mercy, it's good to see you. But is it safe for you to be here?
Gerda. Gerda, I'm fine. At least now I am.
Are you hurt? What's happened? And who is this? One of your comrades?
Not a comrade yet, but a friend. I owe her my life, in fact. Is there somewhere we can talk? There's no telling when the news from Helgen will reach the Imperials.
Helgen? Has something happened? You're right. Follow me. Hod, come here a minute. I need your help with something.
What is it, woman? Sven drunk on the job again?
Hod, just come here.
Raylo, what are you doing here? Ha, I'll be right down.
Uncle Raylo, can I see your axe? How many Imperials have you killed? Do you really know Ulfric Stormcloak?
Hush, Frodnar. This is no time for your games. Go and watch the South Road. Come find us if you see any Imperial soldiers coming.
Aw, Mama. I want to stay and talk with Uncle Rayla.
Oh, bastard has a dagger.
Almost a grown man.
That's right. They added that in the mod.
That's right. Don't worry, Uncle Rayla. I won't let those soldiers sneak up on you.
Now, Rayla, what's going on? You two look pretty well done in. I can't remember when I last slept. Where to start? Well, the news you heard about Ulfric was true. The Imperials ambushed us outside Darkwater Crossing. Like they knew exactly where we'd be. That was 2 days ago now. We stopped in Helgen this morning, and I thought it was all over. Had us lined up to the headsman's block and ready to start chopping.
The cowards.
They wouldn't dare give Ulfric a fair trial. Treason for fighting for your own people. All of Skyrim would have seen the truth then. But then, out of nowhere.
And then another reason, another thing about Creation Club, I don't know, it's just the fact that they're making you pay for, you go from having free mods and now you have to pay for quote unquote premium mods, which are pretty much you can pretty much count it as DLC.
In the confusion, we managed to slip away.
But I don't understand why they just wouldn't make something like that free. I don't know. Who knows? They. It is what it is now, so.
Maybe we can lay up for a while. I hate to put your family.
But I can't appreciate the fact that they're making this
nonsense.
This survival mode thing free for right now.
Don't worry about the Imperials. Any friend of Raylov's is a friend of mine. Here's the key to the house. Stay as long as you like. If there is anything else you need, just let me know.
I'll take your food items because I am peckish.
Is something you could do for me, for all of us here. The Jarl needs to know if there's a dragon on the loose. Riverwood is defenseless. We need to get word to Jarl Valgrif in Whiterun to send whatever troops he can. If you'll do that for me, I'll be in your debt.
Thanks, sister. I knew we could count on you.
I ought to get back to work before I missed, but did anyone else escape? Did Ulfric?
Don't worry. Sure, he made it out. It'll take more than a dragon to stop Ulfric Stormcloak. I'll let them into the house and, you know, show them where everything is.
Help them drink up our mead, you mean? Good luck, brother. I'll see you later.
Don't worry about me. I know how to lay low.